My name is Angela Matz. I work for the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. I'm an environmental contaminants specialist, and I've been working for the service almost 20 years now. I went to grad school, went to undergraduate and graduate school to be a wildlife toxicologist, which is studying the effects of pollution on wildlife. Pollution is a ubiquitous global issue. You know, we live in Alaska, which everybody thinks of as this pristine wonderland. But in fact, there are global pollution issues that affect the wildlife, the fish, and the food we eat here in Alaska. And so, you know, I spent my career kind of studying this, and I still think it's important to do, to continue to document how the byproducts of our society, which is pollution, affect the natural world. Sharing that just information or experiences with students is really one of the coolest parts of my job. This group of students, man, they were really good at cutting open eggs. It's hard to find a group of people, and I've taught this to a lot of people, it's hard to find a group of people that were so conscientious and really good the first time around at following the protocol and paying attention to the details and making it happen. So I'm quite pleased to not only be able to share the information with them, but also that they're doing the job as well as I could. And that is really making me happy right now. So today, the crew was here working on collecting egg contents. We collected eggs from a couple of different loon species, yellow-billed loon eggs that were collected over in the Western Parklands, the National Park Service lands of Cape Krusenstern and Bering Land Bridge National Park and Preserve, and then also some Pacific loon eggs which were collected on the Yukon Delta. Loons are fish eaters. They're at the top of the food chain, and so for their environment, and so they're more likely than other birds to accumulate contaminants. We look in the eggs because for two reasons. Number one, they're a pretty easy sample to collect. We don't have to trap a bird and take a blood sample. We also look in the egg because for many contaminants out there, their biggest effect is on developing young, developing embryos. And we're looking for a variety of contaminants, including some heavy metals like mercury and lead and cadmium, which are toxic. And then we're also looking for some organic compounds, things like pesticides that are no longer used, like DDT, flame retardants, brominated compounds that are used in many applications, including in consumer items like couches and clothing as flame retardants, and those are turning out to be persistent in the environment and somewhat toxic. We're also going to send, after we're done measuring them, we're going to send the eggshells down to the genetics lab, the USGS genetics lab, for their DNA database. DNA is useful for so much. We're always looking to figure out, can we tell individuals? Is this the same bird that laid eggs in this nest or on this lake last year? Are there populations that mix together? Can we tell that from DNA? So those samples will be very useful for that. And that's why we work with many different partners. When you collect samples in the field, it's really fun. You're camping, you're seeing beautiful Alaska and seeing all kinds of wildlife out there. Okay, so it's not always fun. Sometimes the weather's bad. But, you know, a lot of people are attracted to the field of wildlife conservation because they love to be outside and they love to be observing things. And there are a lot of, there is a lot of information you can get that is from the field, and that's where it ends. But when you're collecting samples, you often have to do work in the lab to prep those samples, to get them prepared, or to actually do the analysis. So there's so much of wildlife conservation and wildlife science that we can learn by spending time in the lab and doing laboratory procedures that, you know, you are able to follow your study through from beginning to end. You know, it's I think it's important to expose the students to that because, you know, really, whether you're looking at contaminants or stable isotopes to determine diets or DNA to determine the extent of the population, there's just so much that can be done in the lab that it's clearly part of wildlife science. So with this next generation of scientists, we want to make sure that they're aware of all the questions that can be answered by spending time in the basement, in addition to spending time outside. Thank you.